I think I've done it. I think I've unearthed the 10 worst songs ever recorded in no particular order. Here they are. To get things rolling, released in 1953, Yes Sir, That's My Baby by Harry Carey. Yes Sir, That's My Baby is one of those classic Tin Pan Alley songs recorded by countless artists across the 20th century. So when I came across this recording, I wondered how bad could it possibly be? And then I did a double take at the name Harry Carey because it sounds an awful lot like the Japanese word for something pretty horrific. And then I saw the YouTube thumbnail for this song, and I thought to myself, oh no, it can't be. But it is. So this was recorded by a fellow named Harry Stewart, who made himself up to look like a Japanese man, and then he sang the lyrics in an overly forced Japanese accent over top of like some gongs and what I'm pretty sure are Chinese instruments. And the crazy thing is, this actually got some radio play back in the 50s. Now, listening to this song from a 2024 perspective, man, you know, I hate to say it, but it's so blatantly insensitive, so overtly, shockingly racist, that you kind of can't help but laugh at it. And of course, if you do want to hear any of these recordings, I've got a playlist for you in the description.
Now take the second here to let you know, I got no sponsors today, got nothing to sell, so let's do a little fan appreciation freebie. Over my course platform, I got a mini course called Pentatonic Mastery that goes over the in and outs of everybody's favorite five-note scale. And if you use promo code WORSTSONG, you can get that course completely free. Now, which is my way of saying thank you guys for watching these videos. Thank you guys for being part of this. You can find more at samuraiguitar3.com. I'll also put up links in the description. Anyways, let's get back to it.
Moving on, next on my list is a 90s country song that you all know, The Boot Scootin Boogie by Brooks and Dunn. So to understand my hatred for this song, you gotta know something that's unique to this place that I live, Winnipeg, Manitoba, in Canada. We have these things called wedding socials, and I actively dislike wedding socials, but some people decide that they're gonna get married and they realize it actually is quite expensive to put on a wedding, even though everybody who's invited is expected to give a $200 cash gift. I guess that's not enough to cover their holy matrimony. So the bride and groom put on a fundraiser called a wedding social, which is a trashy party that happens in some smelly ass community center where you're expected to buy cheap, shitty marked up beer and buy tickets to some shitty auction with shitty prizes. What's in it for the people who go? Well, if you're lucky, there's gonna be a complimentary bowl of Cheetos on the fold-up table that's set up. I hate wedding socials, and the worst part is, if someone even remotely connected to your friendship circle is having one, it's kind of expected that you're gonna go. People are too goddamn polite up here. Because I can tell you, there's only a handful of morally compromised people who actually wanna be there. But let me tell you why I hate the Boot Scootin Boogie. At every single wedding social, since the beginning of time, as soon as the clock strikes midnight, this song plays, and the 15 or so people who actually want to be there get up and they do the Boot Scootin Boogie dance step for step. Where did they learn this? Why do they do it? What is this tradition? I have no idea, but it happens every single time without fail. And then after this horrific display of human flesh flailing about the dance floor comes to its conclusion, they bring out a bunch of platters with deli meat on it, and then people try to sneakily put salami on your shoulder without you realizing it. I am 100% dead serious about all this. You can fact check me, you can look it up, it's insane, I hate it all. And even regardless of all that, let's be honest, Boot Scootin Boogie is an absolutely dreadful song. Next up, we have aaaH, yawA, mgmt, aaaH. That's the name of the song. It's by the band Napolean XIV. So there's a song from the 60s and it goes, they're coming to take me away, haha, they're coming to take me away to the funny farm, blah, 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 blah. It's a creepy song. It's annoying as hell. And at some point in my youth, I heard this song. I don't know when, I don't know where, but I have a very negative connotation deep down inside attached to it. And that alone would probably qualify the song for my list. However, the record label decided to take this piece of music, just straight up reverse it, and use that as the B-side for the original song. Noted music author David Marsh once said this about it. It's the most obnoxious song to have ever been placed in a jukebox. It once caused a diner with 40 customers to be evacuated in the time it took to play the record in its entirety. I lasted 15 seconds into it. If you like sensations that are horrible and you like to torture your eardrums, I'd recommend giving it a listen. The saxophonist Kenny G is kind of like the Taco Bell of jazz. He's beloved by the masses, but no foodie would ever consider him a proper taqueria. But hey, he serves a purpose. There's a couple items on the menu that might be seen as a guilty pleasure. However, he does have one absolute shitwind of a quesadilla that comes in the form of his rendition of the Louis Armstrong song, What a Wonderful World. See, the thing is, it's not really a cover, which would be fine. He took the original Louis Armstrong recording, put some 80s production on top of it, and then noodled his sax over top. It takes this perfect recording and paints this big, ugly, clumsy mustache on top of it. And perhaps the best thing to have come of this is jazz great Pat Metheny's ramblings on this. I quote, "By disrespecting Louis, his legacy, and by default, everyone who has ever tried to do something positive with improvised music and what it can be, Kenny G has created a new low point in modern culture, something that we should all be totally embarrassed about and afraid of." I'm not sure I'd go that far, but you know, I'm always in support of a good old-fashioned rage rant. Have you ever heard of Max Martin? He's one of the greatest songwriters ever to have lived, even if nobody knows who he is. He's responsible for many of the biggest hits from the 90s onwards. Like, just go check out his credits. You've heard his songs many, many times. However, there's also the anti-Max Martin, Patrice Wilson. Patrice co-founded an artist development agency back in 2010, where he would recruit and produce, write songs for, and make music videos for young talent. The stuff that came out of there was heralded as some of the worst music ever made after it started gaining notoriety around the internet. Friday by Rebecca Black, Chinese Food by Allison Gold. There's a whole bunch of stuff like this. And with a decade now to reflect on that internet phenomenon, you just gotta feel bad for the kids who got caught up in all this. And one would hope parents now are a little bit more cautious about how they're thrusting their kids upon the internet. Miracles by Insane Clown Posse. This song is something. From my limited understanding with ICP, they're a simple band. And that's not bad. There's nothing wrong with simple. I like simple. AC/DC simple. AC/DC's great. There's always a place in music for simple. But it's when these types of artists try to go deep that, you know, it often doesn't land. And that's what Miracles is, with lyrics like, "Fucking rainbows after it rains. There's enough miracles here to blow your brains. I fed a fish to a pelican at Frisco Bay. It tried to eat my cell phone. You ran away." And maybe one of the greatest lyrics ever written. "Water, fire, air, and dirt. Fucking magnets. How do they work? And I don't want to talk to a scientist. Y'all motherfuckers lying and getting me pissed." And as much as the song has been mocked and universally panned throughout the years, here's the thing. I actually have no idea how fucking magnets work. Maybe it is a miracle. And maybe there is a little juggalo in all of us after all. Last on my list is Shakira's Whenever, Wherever. And you're probably thinking, Sammy G, my boy, that is a straight turn of the century, world beating banger. What are you on about? And I'll concede it starts with a super cool guitar riff before punching into this infectious Latin infused beat, strong melody, soaring hook, what's not to love? But have you ever read the lyrics? "Lucky that my lips not only mumble, they spell kisses like a fountain. Lucky that my breasts are small and humble, so you don't confuse them with mountains. Lucky I have strong legs like my mother to run for cover when I need it." My only explanation is that the lyrics were written in Spanish and then ran through whatever the 2000 version of Google Translate was and then slapped in front of Shakira to sing. The lyrics are just completely deranged and terrible, and it seems like it just slipped by all of us without anyone noticing. Until today. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. The worst songs ever recorded. If you'd like to add something to this list, let me know down in the comment section. I'll let you know if you want to get any of that sweet, sweet Sammy G merch. You can find that at shopsamuraiguitarist.com. We're going to be doing a big ol' overhaul of the merch store, so a bunch of these old designs are going to be leaving. If you like any of them, like the palette Samurai Guitarist, get it now while you still can. Thank you all for watching. Until next time, look after yourselves, look after each other, look after the planet. I'm Samurai Guitarist, and I'll see you again soon.